my children need, but in the mentions with rappers ain't worth the mention. He's on a digit for selling ignorance. I believe in black books and I can see the rap. And I believe in cap, then I agree with capping, capping. I believe in rap. I believe that I'm that.
Kentucky, just to our right, we welcome you into Paycor Stadium in Cincinnati, Ohio. Today, we've got an interesting Week 11 matchup on tap, as it'll be the Green Bay Packers taking on the Cincinnati Bengals.
The NFL season has hit high gear, and off we go in Week 11 on EA Sports.
And a signal there for the fair catch, so this opening drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
Throwing here to start the drive.
That's complete. He finds Jaden Reed.
And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And they'll be left with a second and about a foot.
Well, his first pass attempt of the game, Charles, and the pass rusher's right there to hit him. But no fear. He delivered an accurate ball. Nice catch.
And you never want to see your quarterback getting hit.
Let's go!
But it also sends a message to the rest of the
check,
team
check.
When he's able to take that shot and still deliver downfield.
Check.
Showing a
check.
Little toughness. And the team rallies around him. This
could
really help them on their drive.
Hunt.
Now the man from UTEP. This is Aaron Jones. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line.
They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield. Because
here we go,
he feels
here we
like
go.
He can come back on third down and pick up the first down.
Panther 60.
Tendency. Stay with what you are. Ready. Stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
And that one goes for about six as he's taken down just shy of the 45. Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us need to get
on
him going.
Jump.
Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on
Cowboy
him
80.
Because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. Still won the ball
go
game.
Street.
They leaned on other people to give him the yardage that they needed, but they really want him to
ready,
be
ready.
That guy. And that's what they're doing early in this game.
And they'll hold him to three there as he takes this up to the 47. You talk about this Bengals defense.
Come on.
They were very solid last week in the victory over Baltimore.
Yeah, they gave up 17 points, but that's about what you consider the break-even mark. If you give up 17 points a game all year long, you're thinking you're going to be a playoff team. That's what you're looking for. Room to improve, of course. A pretty nice effort.
Yeah, boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. On now is the Packers punter. As the first drive of the game stalls out, he's on to punt. This is taken at about the 14. Unable to corral him. He fights through. They'll score that a 36-yard punt.
And the Bengals take over first and 10.
Gun. Sahat. 11 mighty. 11 mighty. Sahat.
It's Jacobs to start the drive. Takes it to the 26, just a one-yard gain.
This defense for the Packers very strong in that victory a week ago.
It was a little bit enlightening talking with the defense coordinator about their performance last week, because the feeling was that it was a good, solid performance. They did what they needed to do to get the job done and get the win, but definitely a few lapses that they're looking to correct.
They work now on second and nine.
Done!
Burrow going to get this out to Chase.
Oh, he's hit. He lost the football. Put it on the carpet. But this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same.
The LSU connection. Burrow to Chase for the Cincinnati
on one, ready? 11, Thomas.
Todd. Oh, he tried to fit it in on the slant, and it's intercepted.
And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory. Before we came up to the booth, last thing he said as we were walking off the field, want to play mistake-free football. Well, that just went out
the
window. There's your pick.
And do you remember what you said to me when we were walking up to the booth after he said that? You're like, oh, fatal last words. Every time we hear that, things tend to fall apart a little bit, and that's what we saw there. Didn't get enough on that throw, and it turned into an interception.
A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
Let's go now.
A second and 10.
60 Bobcat, 60 Bobcat. Buffalo 18. Cub 19. Cub 19. Mustang 19. Ready?
He'll drop to throw. And he'll be taken down by the Bengal pressure.
Logan Wilson in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year.
Well, that was second long. Now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
Tough situation to overcome here. Third and 17.
Play clock down to 3, and we're going to get a timeout here. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter.
Shut
the
up.
Bengals with 2 extra
DBs.
A nickel look on third.
Blanketing the passing lanes.
To throw here.
Able to find the open man. That's complete.
And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. How about that? They weather the storm of a third and 17 to pick up the first.
And partner, they're locked in man coverage out left, and they end up running a crossing route. Rounded it a little bit more than a slant.
Ready
he's
up.
Just going to angle himself towards the right side of the field, and that's very difficult for a defender to shadow him across all that ground.
Warrior 70. Go.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it.
A short throw to Musgrave.
Oh, some strong running. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. Add the gain here to the previous play, and it's better than 40 yards total.
Just picking up yardage in bunches here these last few plays. They have moved right down
okay,
the field.
Ready.
And just like that, they're going to be set up with a first and goal.
Hurt.
Now Jones. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to second down.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping it for
tight.
A loss.
Dragon 60. Check smash. Check smash. 18 Rattler. 18 Rattler. 18 Cardinal. 18. Hey, hey. Check. Hustle. Hustle.
They'll try again with Jones. He'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup of about 3.
Partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness, think about running the ball here. Not even a thought, is
yeah,
it?
Defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing it.
Panther Street! Panther Street! Chap 60! Chap 60!
To throw on third and goal. Oh, the ball comes out on the hip, but they're saying it's incomplete.
Oh, that's going to hurt a bit because they needed to come through with a completion there. Now a drive that started with great field position is facing fourth down.
And his kick here is good. And the Packers are off to a 3-0 lead.
So, Charles, they get to them with their first turnover of the game and then make it hurt a little bit extra with a field goal.
And anytime you give the ball up, what's the first thing a coach tells his defense? Don't let them score off of this. You've got to put out the fire. In fact, in 2021, that's what one NFL coach termed his defense, the fireman. Go out there, guys, and don't let them put some points on the board.
Here we go, here we go.
The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive.
Their second drive here, the ballgame, Charles. Remember last time they threw the interception, but the defense held up. It bent a little but didn't break, only giving up the 3 points.
Yeah, obviously they left some points on the table there their last time out, but boy, they have to thank their defense for holding the opposition
to
3 after they threw the pick.
12, 12,
their turn now.
12.
Back out on the field, put together a good drive, and get some points of their own.
And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. 3-0 after one on EA Sports.
On one, ready?
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
Shot!
Here's Jacobs on first and 10. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
The Bengals
here we go, here we go.
7-3 now on the year. And they've been in a great groove. Winners of 7 of their last 10 now on the year.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
And Chase going to pick up a Bengals first down. Up near midfield, spotted at the 48.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around
a
bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in.
And Burrow going to be hit and taken down. They got him. Rashawn Gary. From that outside linebacker spot, gets in there. It's a loss of 9.
Well, on that one, they go with a play fake, CD, but I don't think anybody really was fooled. All eyes were fixated on the quarterback, and they got him to the ground.
And to run
11
this
MT Tate. 11 MT
Tate. You've got
to
make sure that everyone is doing their part. You actually have to sell this play. You've got to sell the run action.
And his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. And he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line.
Well, those have been a problem for him all season, but never quite as much as they have in these last few minutes. Let's count it up now. A pair of picks on his team's last 2 drives and double-digit interceptions this season. I don't care if you're the best in the game or an undrafted rookie. You've got to take better care of the football or you're going to cost your team chances.
70 Timberwolf. Ready, ready.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. And down he goes. They sack him back right around the 41-yard line.
Trey Hendricks
Watson showing off his pass rush repertoire that time.
Ready, ready.
Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here.
Passer
on second 11, and 16.
Check out.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. This one swung out here to Jones. They'll wind up getting just a yard out of it. And they're going to be staring at a third and long here.
I know it was a game, but you have to sense probably a little bit of disappointment there, because when it's out there in open space, I think they expect to get more out of a play, don't you?
Especially when you're getting it to your guy out of the backfield. You're expecting him to be able to create something, be a little more shifty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Good open field tackling held it to an okay
game.
Go,
Rick! Go!
Disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
And a nice special teams job here. This is going to be down inside the 10 at the 7 yard line.
Absolutely love the flexibility of these punters. Their leg drive, able to get it way up in the air, and that allows their punt team
here
to get
go
down there and down it inside the 10 because they've had some time.
The Bengals drive about to get going.
12,
and it's
12,
been a miserable start
12
for them offensively. Obviously, two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have
gun,
to be
gun
stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
Shot.
Play action. It's Burrow. They swing that out wide to Jacobs. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll leave him with a second and just a few inches left. Looked like a pretty good, safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy out in the flat.
And so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about in your progressions, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. Earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now he got to the check down. A nice safe throw and a good one.
A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Exactly what
they
needed.
Here we go, here we go.
There, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Shot.
On first down, they go with Jacobs again. And he'll rumble for about 5, up close to the 40. Decided to hand it off that time on the run pass option.
Here we go, here we go.
Easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
Shot.
They'll stay on the ground with Jacobs. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4 yard pickup leaves him with 3rd and 1.
When you find that kind of yardage,
on
you
one,
be more confident as a
11, 11, 11.
Guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying
11,
it.
11, 11, 11, 11.
Trying to run for it with Jacobs. He's not going to get there. That won't even be close. It was blown up in the backfield. That'll back him up 2 yards and also bring up 4th. So on 4th down, on is Brad Robbins to punt for the Bengals. 2nd quarter, 2 minutes remain. 3-0 our score. On now to punt, Brad Robbins. McKenzie now to return. So a good punt there, but a nice return of 11 yards. And it'll be Packer football here. 1st down and 10. Ready to get their next drive underway. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether
60
it's through the
Bison,
air or
60
on
Bison
the ground.
Ready?
Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Let's go.
I think after that run, the defense getting back in the huddle and looking at each other. And
19 Tiger.
They gave up a significant run, 6 yards.
Riggs,
and now
Riggs.
You're saying to yourself, how do we stop them? And do I have enough confidence to make a play?
Reload!
And here's Jones again on the second down. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
It's been a rough go on the ground throughout the entire game, but after a run like that, they may have found the spark to get their offense kick-started.
From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10.
Go!
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. A short throw to Musgrave. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Come on,
hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
Now, here's a little touch pass as they tap it quickly to their receiver. So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit.
Set 70 Ranger. Check. Hurt. 70 Lion.
Ready. Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. Looking deep here for Dobbs. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's 3rd down.
And they're not going to go quietly into this halftime break. They know they're in for a fight, so they're trying to make every possession count.
Break.
They took the big shot there, but it winds up incomplete.
60 Bobcat! Ready?
On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. Throw caught by Musgrave. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. On now is the Packers punter as he'll come on to kick this one away. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Pulled in at the 24. 31 yards on the punt there. And the Bengals will take over here 1st and 10.
Ready?
The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot. We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved, call a few more plays that target him.
Absolutely, because here we are toward the first half, and that's the first target, not just the first catch, first target. Now Burrow. And for the 3rd time here in this half, it's intercepted. And a potential turning point as they'll get the football in very good field position late in this first half. An unfortunate sequence there, trying to get points before intermission, but now the interception, and their opponents have a chance to possibly pad their lead.
Yeah, they had an opportunity there, and they weren't able to capitalize on it, and that's something that could come back and haunt them later. They're begging their defense now to keep them from scoring before the half ends.
Buffalo 18! Cup 19!
They'll try and start this drive in the air.
Jesus.
Caught. It's Romeo Doubs. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. They'll put it down right at the 40, so call this a 50-yard attempt. And his kick is absolutely perfect. And that will do it for this first half. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down, two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. The Bengals with work to do in this third quarter, but they'll get the football first as we are back underway. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25.
Let's get set.
The Bengals drive about to get going.
Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well, and they've kept them around in this game. Now, they've got some time.
Here we go.
The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
And he'll get about three here as he's out to the 30.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert
on
the
one,
draws,
right?
And other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Todd!
And oh, he's just going to be short here. Barely.
Hey, we're good, we're good,
maybe
we're good. 11, 11.
Fourth and inches.
Todd!
They go with Jacobs. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. They only needed a few inches, but still some anxious moments there. But they do convert on fourth. Oh, on the defensive
side,
that is so
deflating. 11 MT, 11 MT.
They've got to look at each other's eyes on that side of the ball and take each other's measure. You've got them backed up, perfect situation. And what they said to you on the other side is, we don't think you can stop us. Went ahead and got it in that position.
Here we go.
That should never happen.
11 MT, take. 11 MT, take. Dot.
Quick slant caught by Chase. And Chase going to pick up a Bengals first down as he'll be taken down at the 46.
Here we go, here we go.
The pick up there and it moves the sticks.
Dot.
A handoff, Jacobs running to the left. And a pretty good burst right there as he'll take this down to the 33. 75 yards for him on
one right
now as he has been terrific.
11, 11. Shot.
Once again, it's Jacobs. Shedding through the tackle. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
Offensive linemen love creating
one, right?
Space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yards, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. A gain of five, good enough for the first
down. One, ready? Todd!
Here's a handoff to Jacobs running left. And the result here, a pickup of eight. Leaves him with two to go on second down.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down.
Here we go, here we go.
As this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
They will run out of the gun with Jacobs. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. It'll be a gain of two on the play, but they'll remain a few inches short.
Here we go.
With third down looming.
Here we go. Shot.
On third down, here comes Jacobs. And he gets the first down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the six. 3 yards there. Good
Let's
enough to keep the drive moving. Might we see our first touchdown of the game? Here's first and goal. Here's Knight on the handoff. And a little bit of space there takes it inside the 5 to the 3. It'll be a pickup of 4, and it brings up second and goal. When we talk about being on schedule, I think they're on schedule after that run, getting it right down there on the doorstep.
Maybe even a little bit ahead, because now the defense can't dictate with pressure. They're guessing 12, 12, about where 12. You're going to go. I might come right back
11, 11,
the
11, 11.
The same set and see if they can stop him.
God.
Jacobs. And they'll bring him down after just a short pick.
Here we go, here we go, here we go.
About a half yard.
11, 11, 11, 11, 11, 11. Shot.
Jacobs again. And he will not get in. In fact, he might have lost a yard. Back to the 2. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's 4th down.
That was a huge play on 3rd down, so now what? Do you go for it? Do you trust your offense? Or do you want to put
your
defense to try and get the ball back? Me?
11 mighty.
Right
11 mighty.
4th down. Here's Joe Burrow. And it's going to be batted down. And we'll go the other way with the football. They try to throw on 4th and goal from the 2. And this shutout is going to continue as the defense holds again. Set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. Their defense has pitched the shutout. Now they probably need to deliver a little breathing room. Maybe make it a 2-score game as they've got it 1st and 10. And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's 2nd down.
And while they hope to continue this drive, it's really already mission accomplished. They've given enough space now that they have to punt the ball. They've done so with that first run.
Six the Eagle.
They'll send a receiver here in motion right.
Set. Temple. Set.
Back to the ground. This time with Jones. And he's going to be taken down shy of the 10 right around the 9-yard line. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other 3 here on 3rd down? In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
7 Pirates! 7 Pirates!
Gun now on 3rd down. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Part of what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
Now the offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on 4th and 3. They're going to try and throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert. And they turn it over. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And now, boy, the ball's going to go over on downs here inside the 10-yard line.
Here we go.
The kicker fest so far. All points via field goals. They're hoping to change that right here. Firing quickly, but it's incomplete.
You get the sense that they're saying we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long
gone. Here we go.
That they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of
these
plays that they have not been doing so far.
And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. No gain on the play there. They're going to need to come up with something better here on 3rd and goal. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his 3rd down play as we've played 3 quarters. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Bill.
Third and goal. And keep in mind, very possibly four down territory.
11 MT. Shot.
They're passing here. Joe Burrow. And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sacked back at the 9-yard line.
That's a ball he needs to let go of there. Wasn't the most time in the world to work through his progression, but NFL quarterbacks, they've got to sense the pressure. They've got that internal clock, and the ball has to be gone. And if you're not going to escape and run for it, you have to let it go before the pressure gets to you and puts you on the ground.
So kind of disappointing there. I mean, yes, they get the three, but with starting field position like that, three's not what you're banking on.
No, and you just have to wonder if you can afford to let chances like that continue to pass you by. You've got to find ways to get the ball into the end zone and put sixes on the scoreboard.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Fourth quarter, they cling to a three-point lead after the field goal a moment ago. This certainly a very critical drive with still a good chunk of time remaining. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. 40 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
Brandon, sometimes it just comes down to the power of suggestion because I know exactly what they said all week long. We're coming off the open week. We'll have the fresher legs in the fourth quarter, and they will wilt when we get to that point. And right now, it appears that they're thinking that exact thing.
Yeah, offensively, they had the bye last week. Defensively, did not. Is that really a big factor? Is that more talk during the week?
I think the more that you talk about it, the more that you emphasize it, the more sometimes it comes true for your team.
Hot, hot.
And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. If you can keep getting gains like that, Charles, with the lead here in the fourth quarter, I mean, keep running it, right?
No doubt about it, but what the offense coordinator has to do is understand they're going to continue to stack the line of scrimmage. What runs do you have in your arsenal that'll work against a stacked box and continue to move the ball?
Now a second and 2. And they'll send Watson in motion right. Fighting through, and he's got space. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
We've seen
running backs in today's NFL get involved in the passing game. Maybe it's about time more receivers like that get involved in the running game.
And that is something we are seeing more and more in this league, no question about it. That wasn't the biggest of gains, but it was enough to get them a first down. And it continues to test the defense. They have to think on every play about who might end up with the ball.
Ready, set.
From the 43, it's second and 3. Again, it's Jones. The 20. Five. Touchdown, Packers. Aaron Jones, his first rushing touchdown on the year. And the Packers are able to build on to their fourth quarter lead. Carlson's extra point up and good. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. Carlson back out there now to send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25.
Here we go.
The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. Well, that last touchdown we just saw, what an important one. Now it's back to a 2-score deficit for this crew as they take the field here, and they are in desperate need of finding the end zone. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one possession game. Yes. Gotta get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal, don't necessarily need a touchdown. So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Burrow will throw. Looking for Pickens. He's got him on the out route. And he's out of bounds as he gets this down to the 45. And that's good for a gain of 6, and it'll be second down.
Here we go. Gotta go, gotta go, gotta go.
Out of the gun, it's Burrow. Oh, no, he lost the football. And the Packers pick it up. And they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line. Every week we hear talk about create turnovers. In particular, they wanted to force some fumbles. They got one right there.
And it shows you how the game has changed over time. It used to be good enough for a guy to get a sack of a quarterback in the pocket. Now, if you come to the sidelines and you didn't knock the ball free, your coaches are upset.
Let's go.
You. All right, so if you're a quarterback, it starts all the way back in the youth leagues. Take care of the ball, take care of the ball, take care of the ball, because here come the defenders.
Get up.
They'll try to run some clock now with Jones. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
Here we go. Here we go.
Here's second and 10.
Bronco 80, Viking 18, Hawk 70.
Now whistles here, flag down. I think one of the Packer linemen was moving.
Come on.
And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long.
Ready.
Completed out left to Dobbs. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
When you have someone throwing it that well, that confidently, you don't have to call the game in fear at all, do you? You just go ahead and play.
Yep, confidence with a lead to throw it here in the fourth, and boom, he's on the money.
Yeah, you don't have to tuck your head in and go like turtle at this point. You can just go ahead and play.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They'll try the right side with Jones. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 113 yards rushing for him now, as he has been tremendous all day long.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with.
Let's
go now.
And throughout
this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
Being chased out left. And that's going to be incomplete.
Offense was moving it a little bit, had them back on their heels, but they earned a brief pause by forcing the incompletion. That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before they're backed up even further.
Second and 10.
Warrior 70.
Bring a receiver in motion right. And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. He finds his man, complete. It's Reed. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. pass here. Oh, and this one may need to go back to the drawing board. He's going to be swallowed up right away. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. This, in all probability, another run here on second and eight.
19 tight. 19 tight. Dragon 60. Rattler. Panther 60. Panther 60. Ready.
An inside give to Jones. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Aaron Jones with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And the Packers are an extra point away from making this a three-score game. Carlson's extra point up and good. And that'll make this a three-score game now. The lead moves to 17. So now Carlson, after the touchdown, called on to send this one away. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line.
Gun.
The Bengals drive about to get going. Now, this game went off the rails early for them and never really got back on track. And these fans, they were expecting to be on the other side of the scoreboard. But that is not the case as we play on here this fourth quarter. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game.
On one, ready?
It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side. And an inability to advance the ball from the other.
A throw over the middle taken in. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 22 yards there, a first down. Well, those are the types of plays they probably wish they had made more of in the
here
first three quarters.
11 mighty. 11 mighty. Hey, we got to go score.
Here in
let's
the
go.
Fourth, but a nice first down and a pickup on that throw.
Yeah, and this is where as coaches, you're looking for effort and execution, even though the scoreboard is going against you. You want to find out who's going to fight, who's going to scrap, who's going to keep their heads up and continue to play. Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any
here we go,
plays
here we go.
Now. They've controlled this game throughout. And all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with
12,
that
12, 12.
Completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
Burrow's throw taken in here by Chase. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. Clock management, definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores.
On two, ready?
Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
First down, here's Burrow. His throw incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
Here we go.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10.
Shot!
Throwing again, it's Burrow. He's going to have the hook up here to Chase, and he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of 3. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits
here we
of
go.
Run after catch. They're tackling them almost.
Gotta go.
That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Stop.
On third down, Burrow. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play. Now it's Burrow. And that is caught. He's got it for the Bengals. Touchdown. George Pickens, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Bengals are finally into the end zone here in this fourth quarter.
And yeah, that touchdown counts for their team. But I think it counts more for the fantasy guys, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's just something maybe positive to look at.
Let's
on
get
film,
set.
But this one's over, let's be honest.
Yeah, I agree with you totally.
Here we go, here we go. Get in the hot.
And they don't get it. They tried for the two-point conversion there, but unsuccessful. So two scores down. Time definitely not an ally, but here comes the onside kick. And this is going to be... And the ball is loose. Dylan lost it. Oh, and one of the linemen on the other side has got it. And his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line.
Here we go.
This is first and 10.
11. Stop.
Throwing. Burrow. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
When you're leading in the final quarter, your radar has to be up for any potential deep shots. And probably not the last one they're going to see in this game. Not
gun,
as long
gun.
As they hold this lead. Stop.
Here comes second down.
Stop.
To throw Burrow. And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's third down.
You get
Here we go.
These two-minute drill situations, and you've often got tired legs on the offensive
line. Can.
But these defenders, they've been rotating in and out, and they're a little bit fresher and quicker. And the pressure there forced the incompletion.
And now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
Give it big credit for his coverage right there, because when he saw the route break deep, he stayed in position to prevent
here we go,
completion
here we go.
While avoiding any risk of a flag.
Stop.
Here we go. It's Burrow on fourth down. He's going to let it fly. Oh, and that is incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Packers are going to get the football back in excellent field position. He's got the hookup with Dobbs. And he's going to be out of bounds down around the 35-yard line. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And they'll be left with a second and about a foot.
Go! Chop 60!
Looks like he'll throw here. And that is incomplete. 2 seconds left on the clock.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a little more
attention
on that route, and that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
Ready?
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And it's incomplete. They're still throwing to the very end. But now this game is over. So it's all over. A Green Bay victory. And I think the game balls need to be distributed on the defensive side of the football. And I bet that you would agree.
Yeah, if you hold a team under 10 points, that's a job well done. Really well done. So I would say game balls for every starter and every key player who participated in this game.
Now, see, I only like one game ball.
You're handing out multiple,
although I set you up by saying game balls, plural,
yeah,
but
yeah,
I...
But I like where we're going with this, though. You say one to represent,
yeah,
like, the best player of all
yeah.
that, and I say multiples so that you keep everyone motivated.